Have I got an exotic one planned for today? Guys, welcome back. Welcome back to our Omega series, where today I think we're gonna face our very first boss. That's right. We've been working towards this for quite some time now, and I think it's time. I think it's today. I think it's gonna happen. Where are we gonna kill the boss? I don't know. I have no idea. I get the feeling no. I'm probably going in way too prematurely for this, but we're not gonna know until we try. Which is why we're gonna try. We're gonna face a boss today. As simple as that. Now, to do this, there's a few things that need to happen. We're gonna go over that in just a second. But before we do, if you do enjoy the video, please go ahead, punch that thumbs up. Now let's see what we're gonna do. So, long story short, we gotta craft up a new structure. One we don't have just yet, but I have the resources for. I double checked that just to make sure. Why have I got 40 lucky souls here, though? That's interesting. Oh, my goodness, that is so lucky. Lucky souls are, like, the rarest souls that you can possibly find in the world. And I was about to go and craft something using 40 of them. No, Scotty, no. No, I'm going to put them down here to make sure that doesn't happen. We just need 40 generic souls. So, let's just, I don't know, grab a bunch of random souls. Like that. That's such a random assortment. But we've got 20, we've got 40 of them, sorry. Get them in here. And we are going to craft up this beautiful thing right here, the Omega Beacon. Now, as you can see by the description, basically says, in warning, big capital letters, do not place this near your base. Apparently, it destroys foundations within 20 of it. So don't do that. We're not going to do that. I'm not going to place this right here. Thankfully, it's actually preventing me from doing so. Yes, that's a good idea. It's idiot-proof. It's Miola-proof. Fantastic. But long story short, you place souls inside of this structure to summoning creatures. Now, you can actually summon regular dinosaurs through this, which is what I want to kind of have a play with, just to see what we can actually do with it. But long story short, also, I think if you place, let's have a look, sacrificing 100 souls in the beacon will summon a boss creature required for progression. That's simple as that. So we want to basically hop in here and grab like 100 of these ethereal souls, and then it's going to summon us in a boss. Now, the type of souls are going to be pretty a pretty big deal here, and the reason for that is because it's going to depend on the how strong this creature is, or what the boss that ends up kind of spawning in is, and that we can find information on that, I guess, here. Long story short, if we fight a cosmic boss, it's going to have 6x stats. It's gonna absolutely annihilate us. Elementals are a little bit weaker. They got 4x. Ethereals, 2x. So likely we want to do an ethereal. Now, I think it's going to spawn in a random variant. So if we do an ethereal, it's going to be one of these. So you could get a teleporter, a spectral, or a dimensional, spiritual, yada 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 yada. On top of that, guardian, it's a good choice, but they have good armor, so like it's going to be tough to kill them. Lucky, there's some good options there. But I want to make sure we're going to kill this thing, and I don't want to waste all my lucky stuff. Mythical is another good option. It's probably the one we're going to go with, and I'll tell you why. Phoenix. What? It's going to heal up. Whoop-de-doo. Gorgon. What? It's going to freeze me. Yeah, that actually might be kind of tough. Siren. It's going to put me to sleep. Colossus. It's going to be enormous. Fairy. It's going to heal. Pygmy. It's going to be small. Like, mythical. What's mythical? The power of the mythical god. This variant combines the bonuses of the 6. Oh, that's a god. That's the god tier. Oh, okay. Okay, good. Fantastic. 8 times multiplier. I hope it's not going to spawn that in. I actually don't know how this works now that I think about it. But long story short, we got to pick what we want to fight here. Utility might even be the best choice, to be honest. But I don't think I've got 100 utility souls. Either ways, though, we're going to play with this and we're going to see what happens. I know that when we kill them, we're going to end up with... Or if we kill one, we're going to end up with one of these. A boss soul. And I'm hoping we get some other loot along the way as well. We've actually got this, which was from an alpha boss, and this from a beta boss. We picked these up inside some chests, I think. Which is pretty good. And the thing with all of these Omega souls right here, too, is these here can influence what comes out of the boss spawner. Place this soul in the trophy slot of the Omega Beacon to guarantee that your next wild or boss summon is of this variant. So what we can basically do is grab... I mean, I can grab this if I want to. Or maybe we grab... What's something that sounds kind of easy to kill? Because that's kind of what we want to go for. A spectral? It's what? It's going to go a little bit invisible at some point. Or maybe... A colossus? It's going to be big. That could actually be really cool. Maybe we do a colossus. If I had a pygmy, that would be pretty cool as well. But we don't. So maybe I'll just go dimensional. It means it's going to be able to fly. Whoop-de-doo. I'll probably be able to fly as well. Or maybe I'll go... Hold on, there was another one that was pretty good here.
spiritual. That means it's going to be fast. Yeah, I guess there's a few options. Phoenix, whoop-de-doo, it's going to heal up, I guess. Maybe I just get Phoenix. I don't know. We'll just bring a few of these things with us and maybe we'll decide on the fly what we actually end up wanting to do. Before we do, though, we're going to work out who we're going to actually take into this fight. We've got a few options now. We've got our Psychosis Pteranodon. This guy's a beast. But I kind of... I don't know how I feel about wanting to get him. I don't want to get him killed. So it's kind of... It's a tough one. We've also got this beautiful beast down here. Our Omega Gamma Ray Dimorphodon. This thing is amazing. Which is helped by this amazing unique saddle it has. So that's pretty fantastic. Or we've got our Ultimate Vampire Spiner, who I'm actually thinking of using. And the reason for that is it has a lot of health. It's strong. Unfortunately, it's daytime currently, so it's not going to be truly effective. Vampires are double. I think they do double damage at nighttime, so it's probably better off we do this at nighttime, but it's cool. But it has this amazing saddle, which I am currently just going to grab for a second, because supposedly something we have been glossing over and not acknowledging is you can actually imbue these. Think. Yeah, sure enough you can. I don't have enough Omega Essence to make that happen, unfortunately, but what I could do is imbue this as an ultimate, which I assume will give it like a bunch of stats and stuff like that, and we got plenty of Ultimate Essence here, so let's do it. Let's see what we can pull, and I might even do another piece of my own armor just to see what happens. So long story short, if I tap this, something wonderful might happen. This feels like a waste. Maybe I should wait. Hold on. Let me just think this one through. If I want to craft this, is this going to take... It's going to take 10 essence to give me one of these. Let me just try this. Yeah, okay. So we just converted 10 ultimate into one omega. That combined with the 2 omega essence I've got in there, combined with the 15 out here. So we've got 18. I'm just trying to... this is an amazing saddle. The Spino saddle. And I feel like it would be a waste to do it with ultimates. An ultimate... The thing is, I need 180 ultimate essence to then get me all the way to... I think this is going to be an ultimate. All right, never mind. Let's just do it. 3, 2, 1, go. Too late. No turning back now, baby. Let's have a look at what we've ended up with. Damage taken. Woo! Okay. Good damage taken reduction. Swimming speed increased. That's actually good for a Spino. Aggro reduced. And melee damage increase of 12%. Oh, man. That actually sounds pretty good. Do I re-roll it, though? I actually have no idea. Because I can re-roll this with magic fragments. I like some of it, but like aggro reduced, I don't really mind. Melee damage increase. Oh, increased. That's good. And swim speed. I'm just going to re-roll it. I haven't re-rolled one yet. Let's just see what happens. Please. No, that's so much worse. Melee damage increased. Hold on a second. We now deal an extra 55% damage. We take less explosion damage. Our ability damage increase by 16%. Dang it. I don't have a good ability. And then nature. Okay, now I'm re-rolling again. I just wasted so much stuff, but who cares? Armor bonus when equipped. Oh, that's good. That, wow. Damage taken reduced. Oh my goodness. Yes. Okay, that's pretty good. I like that. And while I'm at it, I'm going to go and imbue some pants. Or am I? Or boots. I'm going to imbue some boots for myself. Just ultimately, but extra stamina, explosion damage reduced, nature damage reduced. Man, they love giving me nature damage reduced. Armor bonus when equipped. Dude, that's some good armor. Elemental damage taken. Okay, not bad. The only downside here is I now run around very slowly. My speedy boots are gone. But it's okay because I've got a new mannequin over here with the avalanche set. And these, I believe... belongs to the avalanche set. So we got 2 pieces of avalanche armor. But now that I think about it, am I meant to like wear these? Am I meant to wear a set armor into a boss fight? I don't actually know. No, I was going to ignore that. We're just going to forget about that. It feels so weird to run around so slowly now though. I don't know if I like it. Should I attempt to imbue these? I don't think I'm going to. I think we're going to leave it as is. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm pretty content. Let me go and grab some souls. It's going to be a big old waste, unfortunately, but it is what it is. Ethereal ones, I guess. Yep. Maybe I'll bring some resource. No, that'll be bad, won't it? I'm just trying to think of like what I might want to fight. If we can get an Omega in. Oh, by the way, I went and tamed up some things. We've got all the ultimates now. And I've also, I ended up getting that Lymantria. But like, let's say I want to team up like an Omega Cosmic. I don't think I've actually got Kibble for it yet though. Man, I don't like running around so slowly now. No, I don't have one yet. But I do have an ultimate unstable, so I can get an Omega unstable. Long story short, what I'm trying to say is if I summon in just below a boss, like this, for example, if I get like 99, maybe it'll give me a nice Omega, and then we can try and tame that. All right, we'll take what we need for it just to see what happens, okay? All right, cool. Let's do it. Spino, you're coming with me, friend. I hope we are well-equipped enough for this. Here is your saddle. Watch the armor of this when I equipped it. It's going to turn into 382. Oh, yes. That's awesome. That is so good. And not only that. Hold on. Not only that. Not only that. It also has damage taken reduced by over 1,000. So this thing's going to go nuts. I just got to work out where to conduct this fight is the only thing. We want to go far away from base. Or do we want to be close to base so I can get back when we inevitably die? In fact, this is actually probably a really good base fighting location, the more I think about it. Did I say base fighting? I meant boss fighting, obviously. Yeah, this might actually be the place to do it. Just because, well, my base is up there, so it's not in danger. And I can get back in if I get stuck in a bit of a jiffy. And we need to get back in a hurry. This looks different to what it looked like last time I played this mod. It's kind of nice. If I place these here and I sacrifice, I don't know if this is going to spawn a boss in. I don't think so. Sacrifice souls to lure in enemies that can either be killed or tamed. All summoned enemies will be hostile. More souls increase the chance of a higher tier. 100 souls will summon a boss. All right, so we're just going to do 98. Sacrifice souls. My goodness, you're gonna give me a 5-second cooldown, and it's gonna summon in an unstable, an ultimate. No, I wanted an Omega, an ultimate Kano. Oh no, wait, it's an Alpha Kano. Oh, hold on a second. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Okay, no. I gotta get away from you. Oh, why didn't I bring a flyer for this? What am I? Am I that dumb? Oh, I don't want to fight you. This would be such a good team. You only need 2 kibble, but I need special knockout stuff to knock you out. I can't do it right now. I need compound bows. Yeah, I'm kind of stuck. Come on. I don't know what the radius is on this guy and how long he's gonna chase me for. This Kano might actually be worth taming though. He's really strong. That is a really strong Kano. Unfortunately, not an Omega, but it's an Alpha. Like it's an Alpha. Like an Alpha Kano. Like vanilla Alpha Kano. I just gotta get away from it so I can teleport back to base. Will it despawn though if I try and do that? I just didn't come equipped to fight an alpha dinosaur is the only problem. But I can't tame it if I can just get away. I don't know how long this thing's gonna chase me for. Also, why do we have to have a fog storm right now? Are you kidding me? All right, I'm just gonna go for it. Let's go. Teleport me to base. He's gotta be still chasing me. The thing was so darn aggressive. Okay. He obviously can't chase me up here, so that's good. I don't have to worry about that. But, yeah. To knock this thing out, I should have checked his torpidity. We basically need metal knockout arrows. No, I don't. I need regular... Dang it. I need these. I need as good as I can possibly get. I need metal arrows, though. And then I'm going to craft them into... Okay, so let's get some sedatives going. These are so expensive. I think I'm just going to get... I think we're going to need a lot of these, actually. Let me just craft up 30 of those. Dang it, that is so expensive. Grinder, I've actually ground a lot of our loot recently. But long story short, I want to somehow... I don't want to grind everything. Enable... No, I really don't want to do that. So I'm just going to pull everything across. I want to grind that and that. Oh, but the settings are all janky. I already know this. Disable grind inventory now. Uh-huh. Okay, I got some sedatives out of it. We've got 19 metal arrows. Okay. And now I can transfer everything back. So I have no idea if this is actually necessary. Also, those are an amazing pair of leggings. All right, let me take those out just in case I accidentally grind those up. All right, we've got our arrows. Fantastic. Now, if I chuck these in here. Okay, those are still crafting. but also I need a compound bow, and I know we got a few of them in here. 191%, that sounds decent. The other two aren't quite as good. I think I might actually have a blueprint for a better one. Blue. 480%. I can't craft that though. That's really expensive. No resources to transfer. What do you mean? Oh, they can't be pulled into there, of course. Oh my goodness, I'm actually so... I've got the metal and the polymer. I just don't have cementing paste. 440 of it. Hold on. It would take a while if I decided to craft it, but still, I gotta try. That would be amazing. Wait, what am I even doing? Cementing paste. There's no way I've got the stone. Wait, no, I will have the stone. There's no way I've got the chitin for this. I do. Wait, what? I can craft this thing. Dude, this is an amazing bow. It's so expensive. But it's okay. I gotta do it. It's as simple as that. I didn't got any choice. This is like, it's pretty self-explanatory, I think. I'm just gonna double down and go like this. Is that gonna pull the resources from here? Yeah, I want them both crafting. All right, we're good. Oh my goodness, this is gonna be fantastic. Okay, assuming the garner was still down there, I think I've got what it takes to knock this thing out. That is a big if though, because I don't actually know if it despawned when I disappeared. 3 sedatives per arrow. I gotta make sure none of these miss. That's gonna be probably the hardest part about this whole thing. And I've got 10 arrows to make it happen. Unless these deal, insane torpor. Total torpor potential 28,000 compared to a regular arrow, which is 4,000. Okay, these are amazing. I'm gonna get some of these then. I'm just gonna recraft what we decided not to for whatever reason. Okay, that should be good. That should be good. Is our cementing power? I'm not used to running so slowly. This is really throwing me off. But yeah, we're good for the cementing paste now. I think I need to do this in a fabricator too, which is weird. I haven't crafted anything over here yet. Install blueprint. I have no idea what that means. Let's not do that though. I need some gasoline. I really hope this carno is still just roaming around down there. Okay, turn on. Let's craft this up. I don't know what install blueprint means, but I don't want to do that just in case it breaks something. And we now have an amazing crossbow. You know what I should have just done? I should have just ground down our other crossbow. Compound bow. Literally would have given us everything we needed. Long story short, bam. This thing is going to be so darn good. All right, it's time to head back down. Let's do so on someone who can defend themselves. And this is the good thing about placing it right here. I can also see what I'm doing now. He's not around though, is he? He totally despawned. He totally despawned. There's no way. I mean, there is every way that he despawned. It's not the end of the world. Look, we will find more alphas in the future to use these arrows on, but that is kind of disappointing. I think I'm more disappointed that I lost all my souls. Alpha resilient dialo, go away. Yeah, I'm assuming the fact I can access this means he's not around here. I'm gonna have a little bit of a scan just to make sure. Oh, that's so upsetting. I really messed that one up. Or maybe I didn't. No, he's still alive. He's just camping the bottom of my base. Wow, okay. Oh, he is aggressive too. Okay, this, okay. All right. Okay, this is kind of good, but also kind of terrifying. I guess we're doing this thing. I guess we're not doing this thing. Oh my goodness. He for real right now. Ah, an ultimate what even killed me? A blizzard something. Well, that kind of sucks, doesn't it? Okay, dokily. Not the end of the world, but it is what it is. Is my guy okay over there? Yeah, look at the carno. I just can't, man, if my pteranodon drops down there, he's dead. You know what I need? A glider suit. I don't think I can craft one though. Okay, that's fine. Okay, this is gonna be the sketchiest business I think I've ever done. It's parachute time. This is so bad. I'm gonna regret this. Whee! All right. Desperate times called for desperate measures. Let's see what we can do here though. Yeah, this guy's gonna pursue us until he kills us. I'm so glad I built a base up there and not down here. Yeah, look at this guy. Okay, okay, okay. So I want to see what sort of torpor this be dealing. But at the same time, I gotta get this grapple bay on my hotbar too, I think. Because I feel like I might... It's probably our best bet here is to grapple onto something safe. I don't know what killed me though. Something with a blizzard. All right, it's kind of gonna... Is he gonna come and get a little angry at me? Yeah, here he comes. Here he comes. Let me go and pick you up if possible. Okay, yep. Kano's coming. He's just not. All right, I gotta get his attention, but I don't know how to do it. Unless I, like, get myself up there somehow. All right, let's go for it. Why not? If this thing explodes, I'm dead. He seems kind of stuck, though. I'm just gonna go for it. I'm just gonna shoot him. What's the worst that happens? I'm second guessing here. I don't want to waste these arrows. They're too expensive. But why is he all of a sudden just not caring about me? I'm going to get so close to him and he's going to get really angry with me. Where are you going, dude? Aha, here he comes. Don't explode, don't explode, don't explode. He exploded. He exploded. I don't think I dealt much torpor to him either. 24,000? What do you mean? Wait, what? That's nothing. How are you meant to tame something like this? Can only be knocked out using metal knockout arrows, unique or legendary warp bow, or infinite dinos. I have no idea what that means. Unique slash legendary warp bow. I definitely don't have that. I've got an ascendant. Tempting to try, but still. I'm surprised it didn't kill me with that explosion. I really don't want to waste another arrow either. I think it's obvious why. Can't I fire this right now? Wait, what? Can't fire my bow? What's going on here? Here he goes. Okay. I missed. Got him that time. But that dealt like no torpor. All right. Well, there we go. Okay. This guy's just going to roam around in the wild forever and I can't do anything about it. I could kill it. I could kill it. I don't want to kill it, but I guess I've got no choice. That's actually a little sucky. I was kind of... Oh, man. There's got to be a way to deal torpor to this thing. There's got to be something that I'm just completely missing. Or maybe I just... Yeah, maybe that's just the way it is. Okay, back to the drawing board. Not the end of the world. This time, though, I'm going to go do this boss fight. There's no ifs or buts about it. It's time to make it happen. And if Kano wants to come play along as well... Yeah, you're more than welcome to, buddy. You're more than welcome to come join me. But all I know is I'm no longer safe down on this beach. So we're not going to be doing anything crazy down here no more. All right, let's go. Let's fight this boss. Let's put 100 ethereal souls in. Do we want to fight one of these guys particularly? You know what? I don't care. Select tier. Just a basic boss would be fine. And then summon boss. Summon boss, is that what we're gonna do? Oh gosh, it's on. Here we go. Here we go. No more playing around. It's boss fighting time. Hopefully boss stomping time. Let me get my health potions over as well. And we got ourselves a warp dragon with 20 million health. Are you kidding me? All right, fine. Let's go. Oh, I am not strong enough for this fight. Oh, I am not strong enough for this fight. There's just no way. Although... He seems to have warped inside of me. Hold on a second. Hold on. Hold on. No, no. I might have just let him out. That's okay. Okay, this is actually working. This is pretty good. I'm pretty low on... Not low on health, but... Okay. No, I liked it when you were stuck... I liked it when you were stuck there for a second. Okay. Okay. We've got him down 2 million. He's 10% down. And his fire breath is doing absolutely nothing to me. Is that because I've got my armor? It might be the armor. I think my imbued armor is protecting me from his attacks. You know the armor that said... There was, well, one of the stats on this. One, I've got the armor rating. But two, I've got the damage reduction of 1,000. So if his fire breath attacks don't damage me for over one... Okay, he just dealt me for 161,000 damage. Just as a heads up there. But if his fire breath only deals like 1,000 damage a hit... Once my armor is applied, it means none of it is damaging me. I think that's literally the case. Oh my goodness. Okay. Here's the deal though, if I didn't upgrade my armor, I think this thing would pretty much like one shot me. But also he's just kind of sitting there. He's just sitting there getting attacked. So that's, I got that going for me as well. Not gonna lie, I'm pretty tempted to go to the water. And get my water buff. I just don't want to risk him walking into the water and then flying, because sometimes that happens in Ark mods where something like a dragon or a manticore. I'm just gonna do it. Let me go and get this water. Sometimes like a dragon or a manticore needs to actually hit water for it to take off from the ground. It's a bit weird. But yeah, look at that. We've got a little bit of a damage buff there. 71,000. I'll take it. We got this guy 40% down. This is good. All right. Good. Success. Successful first boss fight. This makes me feel so much better after that failure of an alpha team over there. I think I'm going to have to work out what went wrong with that alpha team though. Because I expected my arrows to deal a lot more torpor than that. And I'm shocked that it didn't. Unless there's something glaringly obvious that I missed. Like, surely there's just, I don't know, I missed something. I have to have. The torpor on these arrows is meant to be a lot higher than a regular arrow. Plus the bow is like a million times better as well. Yeah, I'm confused. I'm really confused about that. But it doesn't matter, because I'm about to have my way with my very first boss. Buddy. You should have been more prepared for this one. Old warp dragon, you think you're all fancy and stuff? Well, you're 2/3 of the way dead. And I'm only halfway dead. I haven't used a single health potion, mate. So come at me. Nice fire breath.
Does absolutely nothing to me, though. Absolutely nothing.
And you're about to fall below 75% of your health. So get wrecked.
Get wrecked.
Man, I got levels up my sleeve. I should go and allocate as well. Yeah, there's like an extra 1,000 damage in each of those hits now. Lovely. It's actually like nothing noteworthy. I don't actually know if I'm better off fighting. I don't know if I attack more frequently when I'm down, but yeah, I'm not going to take the 20,000 damage reduction.
Let's go! 3 and a bit million remaining.
We have ourselves an absolute slayer on our hands here. I really got to somehow get myself a Pteranodon saddle blueprint now. Or just a Pteranodon saddle and then I can imbue it and it can be amazing. Let me just check this thing again. Maybe it's impulse damage? Maybe that's why the fire isn't affecting us. I don't actually know what impulse damage is, but yeah, I like that the fire ain't hurting us. His little warp ability though, that's what's dealing 160 million to us. Now just imagine if this Spino actually had a hit that could deal good damage. Like imagine if we were doing this fight at nighttime. I'd be an absolute machine right now. I'd be dealing 120,000 damage a hit. We'd kill this guy at half the time, but it doesn't matter. He's dead regardless. 500,000 left. 400,000, 300,000, 200,000, 100, and finished. Nice. Oh, so nice. Very, very nice. Where is that soul? There you are. Now, can I harvest you? You betcha. We got our warp boss soul. And the first boss is conquered. We got some omega sedatives, beta experience potion, some stamina. We got some knockout arrows. Yay. Some elements and some more health potions. Yeah, we got some decent stuff there. We also got 5 boss essence, which is pretty much the next step above omega essence, in case you're wondering. But we unlocked a whole bunch of stuff just then too. A lot of tech stuff. I guess we killed a dragon, so it makes sense. But what I'm curious about is tech boots. Where are they? Because I want those. I got a pair of tech boots. There they are. I got a pair of tech boots that I need to learn to wear. So I guess now I need to try and get myself a gorilla out of this or something and then fight that. But that's good. Knowing that I can learn tech gear out of this thing here is a pretty good thing to know. That's going to be very handy now that I know that. I'm very tempted, because I still got more souls on me. I'm tempted to... Wait, didn't I? I thought I brought more. I guess that's all I brought. I wasn't even wearing this. My amazing charm. Oh well, that's all good. Well, that's it. Okay, we defeated our first boss. I'm gonna leave this here. Activate Titan spawns? No, thank you very much. No, let's not do that just yet. But cool. I'm very happy with that. That is fantastic. That is great. The only downside from this entire day is the fact that Alphacano still lives in the wild currently. And other than kill it, there's nothing I can do about it. Can't tame it for whatever. I can't deal torpor to the darn thing. There he is. How did I literally deal so little torpor? Like, I want to go and shoot it again just to see what happens, but I know nothing's going to happen. Unless there's information in here about it. Okay, that's the beacon boss information. Variants. There's nothing about alphas in here, so it doesn't really matter. Eh, it is what it is. Let's get back home.
Ah, home sweet home. Well, another successful adventure completed. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We're going to be doing a lot more boss fights in the future, but I think I did learn I need to do more damage. I think that is what I took from all of this. Need to do more damage. Got to find a way to do more torpor to that.
Man, I could hit that with a warp bow from up here, couldn't I? Oh, I just stepped out of range, that bugger. Never mind. It's a fantasy anyways. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the next one tomorrow. I have no idea what we're going to be doing in it, but I'm sure we're going to be doing something great. But yeah, I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.